Hey, today we're going to learn how to generate drafts of personalized emails all in Google Sheets. Before we get going, you'll need an active Gmail account, access to Sheets, and we're also going to be using an add-on called Prompt Loop that lets you use AI models in Sheets. Let's get started. What we're looking at is a Google Sheet that I've put together with some examples of customer feedback. This could be responses to a survey, emails, notes to you, or really anything to get started with. I'm going to try to draft emails and generate subject or heading lines for realistic customer outreach so that I can get back to everyone who wants help with my company's tool, Prompt Loop. So what we see on the left is our highlighted in yellow customer feedback. What we're going to do is take these feedback points and turn them into, just like you would if you're doing all this manually, individualized value propositions, taking what our product does, what the customer needs, and explaining to them exactly how you can be helpful. So in column D, we have the value prop. Again, this is just going to be a copy all the way down in most cases. This is tailored right whatever your company's value prop is. The first time we're going to use the tool Prompt Loop is going to be in our category and message generation. This is going to use an AI model, which is going to interpret all of this information and understand what type of categorization we need and what type of messages we need written. So the first thing we'll need to do is navigate to our extension bar. You'll see Prompt Loop already shows up for me. If it doesn't show up for you, you can go on to Get Add-ons and search for it, and it'll be right there. For me, I'll click Activate, which enables Prompt Loop inside this sheet. And now with that one click, I have a new formula. So I'll start typing our formula. There's lots of tutorials linked in this video and on our website. And the first thing I need to do is start to select what will be my input examples. So with Prompt Loop, it's show not tell. So you're going to grab a set of inputs that you want and a set of outputs and use that to tell the formula what exactly you want done. So in our case, we want to take the feedback alone, and then our output, note F4 to lock that reference. I'll select our categorization output examples because our first step is to select the category. And then lastly, we want to select the target. So this is not a dynamic reference. B9 in this case is the new piece of feedback that I want to use to generate a category, and we'll click enter and see how well it works. So you'll see it's loading. Extract emails is what this customer is effectively asking for. So you want to check these, make sure you have good enough examples before you get going. With a quick glance, we are ready to go with this. So I'll just drag this all the way down, and you'll see it's going to do that exact same calculation for these next two examples. So write title for a YouTube video, write thank you notes for this last one. Great. So that's step one. Think of that as the first ingredient to the cake we're baking. So next, we're going to go very similarly. Prompt Loop, same inputs. But for outputs, we're going to include, for inputs, we're going to select both the customer feedback points, the value prop, and the category. So all of that. And the output is we want one kind of short, sharp sentence about why what our product does is perfect for this particular problem. Again, all of this is drafts. You'd never send a generated piece of content directly to customers, but it can get you started on thousands of emails that you're going to write anyway. But now you have a much better head start. So again, we're going to select the target to be the exact same format as our examples, but with new information. So I'll select B9 through E9 here and click enter. So again, formula's looking at these outputs based on these inputs, and it's going to write the exact same format for the new inputs that I just selected. So three pieces: inputs, outputs, and target. So here's our sentence, and we can simply drag this all the way down. There's nothing in here, so I'm going to delete these. Again, you could use this for as many examples as you needed. I'm only doing about six here, but you'll see this sentence is different and tailored to all of these specific feedback points. The last step has nothing to do with Prompt Loop. This is just a little Gmail Sheets trick. Is we have a formula here with a specific syntax for a Gmail link to generate an email to a specific person. You could have an email list as a column with no macros, no plugins, and no coding. We can have a link that if I select this into a new tab, I can generate with a BCC, a custom subject that you'd obviously change, and then that first sentence to get started on the draft, all with one click. So we used Prompt Loop for this demo and Gmail, but this is a quick way to start really getting back to your customers at volume, not robo emailing, but being really thoughtful about what you're sending. If you thought this was helpful, check out more, and please get in touch if you want more advanced and tailored use cases and help with your own business. Thanks.